and we're here with Miss Frederick 2000. Why don't you go ahead and introduce yourself to our audience and tell us a little bit about what you're doing now.
Hi, Craig. I'm Miss Frederick 2000, Sonia Stahl Davis, and I currently operate Urbana Dance Studio in Urbana, Maryland, and provide dance education to children from the ages of 3 to adults. So this is our third year operating out of the Landon House. Just teaching children about arts education and, sharing my love of dance.
And who are you working with there?
Kevin Dolan.
Okay. And what other instructors do you have at the...
I actually have a lot of people that are involved in the community. I have Miss Frederick 2001, Shannon Babe Thomas, and I have Miss Frederick 2002, Michelle Ori Howard. And I'm also working with one of the state individuals, Tammy Frazier. And I have a professional ballerina also at the school teaching classes for me, Christy Winman.
So just about any specialty somebody wants to pursue, they can pursue it with you all. Now, do you have some youngsters with some real talent that we can keep an eye on and that we're going to...
We sure do. We actually have a small competition team that we started. It's about 15 children this time. We have tops, juniors, and seniors, and we just went to competition recently and won some gold medals. Qualified for a first national competition.
Okay, what's your website address if people want to check you out?
My website address is urbanadance@adelphia.net. Well, that's my email address.
Okay.
And you can locate me under Frederick.com.
Okay, and just do Urbana Dance keyword on Frederick.com and you'll find her website. Thanks again, and this is going to be Frederick.com keyword pageant. You'll be able to find this podcast as well. Thanks again.
Absolutely. Thanks, Fred.
You are so beautiful. To me.
Okay, here we are at the Afterglow party. This is Laura Kelly, the first runner-up in Miss Maryland. And I know you've been involved in this organization for quite a while. So why don't you tell us a little bit about your experiences, including tonight, and including past titles that you've had and so on.
Sure. I started 5 years ago. I was with Howard County. From there, my first year I was in the top 10 of Miss Maryland, which was very exciting. And my second year I was in Frostburg, and I was in the top 5. I was the third runner-up. And my third year I was in Mountain City, and I did not place in the top 10 at Miss Maryland. I took a year off to reevaluate everything, and I came back this year as Miss Annapolis, and it has been an amazing experience. I could not have asked for more. Miss Maryland program is such an acceptable, exceptional organization. The Miss America organization is the leading scholarship for women in the entire world, and that's definitely something to be proud of, to be a part.
And has it helped you with your education?
Absolutely. I was actually at a community college for 2 years while I was deciding where I wanted to go to study music. And when I stumbled upon the Miss Maryland organization, that enabled me to go to the private university conservatory style music school that I really wanted to go to. I graduated about a year and a half ago from the Benjamin T. Rome School of Music, which is part of the Catholic University of America, with my bachelor's music degree in musical theater. So I'm very, very proud that I was able to accomplish that. I would not have been able to do it without the Miss Maryland
organization. Great. And what is your platform?
My platform is Options and Adoptions, improving the foster care and adoption systems within the United States.
Great.
I've done a lot of work working hands-on with foster care children. I'm a certified CASA. We work through the juvenile court system with foster care children. I also have a school program to go into the middle school just to talk about adoption and allow the children in the middle school the opportunity to ask questions about adoption. And at that age, they're curious about things, and you might want to ask somebody, well, why didn't your parents want you, or who are your real parents? And just explain to them the different ways that you can talk about adoption, and that it is okay to ask questions, but there's an appropriate way to do it. And it's very interactive. We do word searches and true or false and timetable. So it was so much fun to establish that, and I already have set up. up for the next 20 years. I would not have done any of this without the Miss Maryland organization.
Great. So, and so one more question. What do you plan on doing now? What's next?
Well, I kind of put everything on the back burner because I didn't know what was going to happen this year. So I don't have anything immediately coming up. I was called last week and offered a part in Cinderella at the Olney Theater, which is a very well-known theater in Maryland.
Cool.
So I'm very excited about that. The rehearsals start at the end of October. So in the meantime, I'm just going to be auditioning, and the plan was, when I'm finished competing with Miss Maryland, to save up more money and move to New York City and just try and make it on Broadway. So
great.
We'll see.
Well, congratulations and good luck.
Thank you.
I'm sure you'll do a great job at whatever you attempt to do.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations.
And thank you for everything you do and the pictures. And I still go to the website from when I was Howard County 5 years ago. I still have the pictures.
And these, the photos from earlier today are up, by the way, Frederick.com, and keyword Miss America, and you'll see the article in the link.
Okay, thank you.
Take care now. Bye-bye.
You are so beautiful.
A little bit of background as far as your competition history, and then tell us a little bit about your platform.
Right. So this year was my first year competing, which
wow.
I'm very excited about. I've worked very, very hard to be here today, and obviously today it's paid off in my favor, and I'm very excited about the year ahead of me. My platform is skin cancer awareness in children and young adults. Last April I was diagnosed with melanoma, which is the most severe kind of skin cancer. I was diagnosed with stage 2, which is borderline malignant, which means that if I had waited about a month, I probably wouldn't be here today.
Oh, geez.
Because of my doctors and because of the preventative measures I now take, I've been able to overcome that. So my journey ahead of me is to go out there and speak to these children and these young adults about skin cancer and really make them aware of the dangers that the sun and tanning beds does expose.
Okay, now for those who weren't at the competition, what was involved in the competition? What were the different stages?
All phases of competition. There's on stage question, there's bathing suit, talent, and evening gown, and then our interview, which is about 12 minutes long. My talent was dance.
Dance? And what type of dance?
Lyrical dance. I've been dancing since the age of 2, about 20 years now I've been dancing, and it's the joy of my life. It's made me the person that I am today.
Wow. And one other question I'd like to ask you. This is going to be on a technology-related podcast and also on Frederick.com and WashingtonCounty.com. Do you have any tech toys that you like to play with? Any kind of technology?
Definitely my iPod. That has been my savior for dance the last couple of years. It's very handy, and now that they have the mini iPods that you can attach to your arms and things like that while I'm dancing, it's really nice to not worry about having a big jukebox or radio or anything like that. I can just have my iPod right on my arm.
Now, do you use iTunes?
I don't use iTunes. Most of the stuff that I download is from my CDs that I purchase or from my computer. So.
Okay, because if you download iTunes, you can subscribe to this podcast and you can watch your podcast.
Oh, really?
On iTunes.
Well, then I will definitely do that
download.
Now. There we go.
Now, this podcast is called 77 Bird, like the numerals 77 Bird. If you put that in your search in iTunes, you would find it. You'll also be able to find it by going to Frederick.com, keyword pageant. There'll be links to everything. So anyway, congratulations.
Thank you.
And
so
what's
much.
Ahead of you for this next year as Miss Maryland?
This next year, basically just going out and talking about my platform. And the Miss America organization is changing rapidly. She's now becoming a very contemporary businesswoman. So not only promoting my platform, but getting out there and really promoting the Miss America organization and the wonderful opportunities that it offers to women in today's society.
Fantastic. Now I'm going to go back a little bit so we can see this gown. This is a wonderful gown. Where did you get this gown?
We got this at a store called Octavia in Baltimore. It's made by
Giovanni. Can you turn around for us so we can see the back of that? Fantastic. Well, congratulations again. Enjoy your party. Geez, it's Oh, it's 12:30. This must have been a long day for you.
Yes, we have.
Well, enjoy it.
Thank you very
much. Take
care. You must have been a beautiful baby. You must have been a wonderful child. When you were only starting to go to kindergarten, I bet you drove the other boys wild. And when it came to wind blew the ribbon, I bet you showed the other kids how. I can see the judge's eyes as they handed you the prize. I bet you made the cutest bow. Oh, you must have been a beautiful baby. Baby, look at you now. I must have been a beautiful baby. You must have been a wonderful child.
This is another 77 Bird podcast brought to you in conjunction with AreaGuides.com. We hope you enjoyed the show, and if you get a chance, attend one of these local pageants. Go to Frederick.com or AreaGuides.com, keyword pageant, you'll learn all about them. A lot of photos from previous years, and it's a great program. These young ladies earn scholarship money and then go out and really make an impact in the community. Again, thanks for tuning in. This is 77 Bird Podcast.